Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. A reading from Matthew 21. When they neared Jerusalem, having arrived at Bethphage on Mount Olives, Jesus sent two disciples with these instructions. Go over to the village across from you. You'll find a donkey tethered there, her colt with her. Untie her and bring them to me. If anyone asks you what you're doing, say, the master needs them. He will send them with you. This is the full story of what was sketched earlier by the prophet. Tell Zion's daughter, look, your king's on his way, poised and ready, mounted on a donkey, on a colt, foal of a pack animal. The disciples went and did exactly what Jesus told them to do. They led the donkey and colt out, laid some of their clothes on them, and Jesus mounted. Nearly all the people in the crowd threw their garments down on the road, giving him a royal welcome. Others cut branches from the trees and threw them down as a welcome mat. Crowds went ahead and crowds followed, all of them calling out, Hosanna to David's son. Blessed is he who comes in God's name. Hosanna in highest heaven. As he made his entrance into Jerusalem, the whole city was shaken. Unnerved, people were asking, what's going on here? Who is this? The parade crowd answered, this is the prophet Jesus, the one from Nazareth in Galilee. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread garments and branches along his way. Bless these branches and those who carry them. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross, so that joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of Christ, amen.
We sing our processional hymn.
Thank you.
Let's join together in the prayer. Everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. You guys can have a seat for a minute. I'm going to do the announcements here real quick, okay? And then I'm going to do the children's message. So are you okay hanging out for a minute up here? All right, good. Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning. Welcome to St. Peter's Lutheran Church on this Lord's Day, this Palm Sunday, the beginning of Holy Week. There's a lot going on here this week, and after worship today, if you would like to receive Holy Communion, we do have quiet communion. You just move up to the front pews, and I'll invite you to the altar rail after the rest of the congregation has departed. This afternoon, there's bowling. Who's going to go bowling? Yeah? I'm going to go bowling. It's going to be super fun. We'll meet at the Voyager Lanes at 1 o'clock, and we'll go bowling. And so tomorrow is newsletter deadline. There's quilting tomorrow at 9 a.m. and Monday night Bible study at 6:30. Tuesday prayer shawl at Barb Olson's choir practice at 6:30. Thursday is Maundy Thursday, such a holy night of the church year, such a special service. Some of our youth will be having their first communion for the first time, and so just a special night. We do the stripping of the altar. There's Holy Communion for everyone at that service. Please come. On Good Friday at noontime, there's a community Good Friday service. There's 8 different clergy, including me. We've put this service together for those who might want to come to hear to the 7 last words of Christ at noontime. There's a lunch following. This is at Trinity in Detroit Lakes. I hope to see you there. And as always, we have the Tenebrae service in the evening, which is the service of gathering darkness. We hear the story from the last night of Jesus' life. The sanctuary is very dark. It gets darker and darker. In fact, the word Tenebrae, it means gathering darkness. So it's the service of gathering darkness. Very special. I hope you will come. And then on Sunday, it's Easter morning. Our worship is at 9:00, and there's rolls and coffee before and after church. It's going to be a great morning. I hope to see you here. Are there any other announcements this morning? All right. Well, now, back to you. How are you this morning? Yes, you sounded really good. That was nice. That Hosanna, Hosanna. Do you know why you sang Hosanna? Oh, and can you give me my phone? What? Do you know why they said Hosanna? When Jesus was coming into Jerusalem and they were waving the palms, it was this word of praise. Yes, it was a word of praise. And, first let me show you something. I wanted to show you some pictures of some different flags and see if you can tell me where they're from. Do you know where that flag is from? Where?
Norway.
Norway. Very good. Very good. All right. How about this flag? Where's this from?
Sweden.
Sweden. Good job. Kids know their flags. How about this one? Yeah?
American flag.
It's not American. What do you know? No, not quite. No. Yeah? No. Do you know?
Germany.
Very good. Very good. Ding, ding, ding. All right. One more. What's this? Do you know?
Canada.
Very good. You know your flags. And we have the American flag there, over there. It's always hanging here. And do you know what flag this one is? Do you know what flag this is? Yeah? Anyone?
Minnesota?
No, it's not Minnesota. Yeah? No? Does anyone know? We should look at that if you don't know what this is. Here, let me scooch through here. I'll hold it up and then you might know what it is. Do you know what's the symbol at the top there?
A cross.
A cross. Yeah, it's the Christian flag. And so we have the United States flag, but we have the Christian flag here because we know that Jesus is our King. And now, this is something I just learned, and maybe you knew this a long time ago. Your mom gave you milk? Yeah, that's good. That's good. Milk is good. I just learned this, but you probably knew this a long time ago. But a long time ago, they didn't have flags. And so waving palm branches was like, you know how people in parades, they'll wave flags, you know, to show their patriotism, their love for their country, or their candidate, or whatever. But back then, they waved palm branches, and they were showing that they wanted Jesus to be their, what, do you know? Their king, yes. They loved Jesus, and they wanted him to be their king, and of course, over the course of the next days, things changed a lot. But did you want to say something, honey? You what?
I saw that one where Jesus was riding the donkey.
Yes, that's the story, right? That he was riding in on the donkey and they put down the palm branches. But that's the reason they were waving the branches was because they wanted Jesus to be their king. Do we want Jesus to be our king? Yes, of course we do. Every day we're so thankful for him and the ways that he loves us. And I hope that you will come this week. We have special services on Thursday and on Friday, and we'll get to hear all about this story about Jesus' love for us. Will you pray with me? Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for these kids, and thank you for their willingness to lift up their voices and sing for us of your love. Hosanna. We are so thankful. Lord, bless these children. Guide them and guard them, and help us all to be your people. Help us all to share your love with the world. And we pray all these prayers and the prayers in our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, so the children, there's some treats here if you'd like to get treats on your way out. And I think I see the choir made it. Perfect timing. The choir can come forward as the kiddos make their way out. Does he help me?
With what?
All right, I've been informed the whole choir is not here, and so we're going to begin then with our You're just taking your place. Okay, you can do that. All right, so we'll proceed with the first reading, and then when the whole choir's here, we'll stop and do the choral part. So go ahead, Andy.
Our first reading today is Matthew 26, verses 14 through 25. Then one of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What will you give me if I betray him to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that moment he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus saying, "Where do you want us to make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is near. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.' So the disciples did as Jesus had directed them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, 'Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me.' And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after another, 'Surely not I, Lord.' He answered, The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." He replied, "You have said so."
Thank you to the choir for being with us this morning. What a blessing you are. And let's continue with our hymn, How Great Thou Art.
The second reading this morning is from Matthew 26, verses 26 through 35. While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. For this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will never again drink of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you. Jesus said to him, truly, I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times. Peter said to him, even though I must die with you, I will not deny you. And so said all the disciples. The end of the reading.
The third reading is from Matthew 26, verses 36 through 56. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, sit here while I go over there and pray. He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me. And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not what I want, but what you want. Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, so you could not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Again he went away for the second time and prayed, my Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done. Again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for a third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, are you sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived and with him, was a large crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, the one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him. At once he came up to Jesus and said, greetings, Rabbi, and kissed him. Jesus said to him, friend, do what you are here to do. Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. Suddenly, one of those with Jesus put his hand on his sword, drew it, and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to him, put your sword back in its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say it must happen this way? At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds, have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me, as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place, so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled. Then all the disciples deserted him and fled.
Matthew 26:57-68. Those who had arrested Jesus took him to Caiaphas and the high priest, in whose house the scribes and the elders had gathered. But Peter was following him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and going inside, he sat with the guards in order to see how this would end. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for false testimony against Jesus, so that they might put him to death. But they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward and said, This fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and build it in 3 days. The high priest stood up and said, Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you? But Jesus was silent. The high priest said to him, I put you under oath for the living God. Tell us if you are Messiah, the Son of God. Jesus said to him, You said so, but I tell you. From now on, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven. Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, He has blasphemed. Why do we still need witnesses? You have no heard in blasphemy. What is your verdict? They answered, He deserves death. Then they spat in his face and struck him. And some slapped him, saying, Prophesy to us, you Messiah. Who is it that struck you?
Our next reading is from Matthew chapter 27, verses 1 through 26. In the first light of dawn, all the high priests and religious leaders met and put the finishing touches on their plot to kill Jesus. Then they tied him up and paraded him to Pilate, the governor. Judas, the one who betrayed him, realized that Jesus was doomed. Overcome with remorse, he gave back the 30 silver coins to the high priest, saying, I've sinned. I've betrayed an innocent man. They said, What do we care? That's your problem. Judas threw the silver coins into the temple and left. Then he went out and hung himself. The high priest picked up the silver pieces, but then didn't know what to do with them. It wouldn't be right to give this, a payment for murder, as an offering in the temple. They decided to get rid of it by buying the potter's field and use it as a burial place for the homeless. That's how the field got called Murder Meadow, a name that has stuck to this day. Then Jeremiah's words became history. They took the 30 silver pieces the price of one priced by some sons of Israel, and they purchased the potter's field. And so they unwittingly followed the divine instructions to the letter. Jesus was placed before the governor, who questioned him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said, "If you say so." But when the accusations rained down hot and heavy from the high priests and the religious leaders, he said nothing. Pilate asked him, "Do you hear that long list of accusations? Aren't you going to say something?" Jesus kept silence, not a word from his mouth. The governor was impressed, really impressed. It was an old custom during the feast for the governor to pardon a single prisoner named by the crowd. At the time, they had the infamous Jesus Barabbas in prison. With the crowd before him, Pilate said, "Which prisoner do you want me to pardon, Jesus Barabbas or Jesus the so-called Christ?" He knew it was through sheer spite that they had turned Jesus over to him. While court was still in session, Pilate's wife sent him a message. "Don't get mixed up in judging this noble man. I've just been through a long and troubled night because of a dream about him." Meanwhile, the high priests and religious leaders had talked the crowd into asking for the pardon of Barabbas and the execution of Jesus. The governor asked, "Which of the two do you want me to pardon?" They said, "Barabbas." "Then what do I do with Jesus, the so-called Christ?" they all shouted. "Nail him to a cross." He objected, "But for what crime?" But they yelled all the louder, "Nail him to a cross." When Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere and that a riot was imminent, he took a basin of water and washed his hands in full sight of the crowd, saying, "I'm washing my hands of responsibility for this man's death. From now on, it's in your hands, your judge and jury." The crowd answered, "We'll take the blame, we and our children after us." Then he pardoned Barabbas, but he had Jesus whipped and then handed over for crucifixion.
A reading from Matthew, chapter 27, verse 31 through 56. After mocking him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. As they went out, they came upon a man from Cyrene named Simon. They compelled this man to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of a skull, they offered him wine to drink, mixed with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his clothes among themselves by casting lots. Then they sat down there and kept watch over him. Over his head they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two bandits were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by deride him, shaking their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priest also, along with the scribes and elders, were mocking him, saying, "He saved others. He cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross now, and we will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now, if he wants to, for he said, 'I am God's son.'" The bandits who were crucified with him also taunted him in the same way. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land, and until 3 p.m. Then about 3:00, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "This man is calling for Elijah." At once one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." Then Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two. From top to bottom, the earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. After his resurrection, they came out of the tombs and entered the holy city and appeared to many. Now when the centurion and those with him who were saints who had fallen asleep were raised, after his resurrection, they came out of the tombs and entered the holy city and appeared to many. Now when the centurion and those with him who were keeping watch over Jesus saw the earthquake and what took place, they were terrified and said, "Truly this man was God's son." Many women were also there, looking on from a distance. They had followed Jesus from Galilee and had provided for him. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee.
Thank you.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you that Holy Week has begun, and we pray that you help to keep this story, this old, old story, close in our hearts and in our minds. Lord, give us your wisdom each day. I pray for each member of this congregation, Lord, for this community. I pray that your Spirit would move mightily among us, that you would give us strength for the challenges we face, that you would give us your guidance in all things. Lord, today we pray for those who are lonely, for those who are sick in any way. We pray for those who are facing death, that your comforting presence is near, and help us to bring comfort to each other. We pray for those who are grieving. Lord, so many prayers we bring in here each week, and you know them all already, but we lift them up to you along with all of our praise every day as we pray the prayer you taught us how to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The final reading. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who was also a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be given to him. So Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn in the rock. He then rolled a great stone to the door of the tomb and went away. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were there, sitting opposite the tomb. The next day, that is, after the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said, "Sir, we remember what that impostor said while he was still alive. After 3 days, I will rise again. Therefore, command the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may go and steal him away and tell the people he has been raised from the dead, and the last deception would be worse than the first." Pilate said to them, "You have a guard of soldiers. Go, make it as secure as you can." So they went with the guard and made the tomb secure by sealing the stone. This is the word of the Lord. Please join me in the benediction. Let us keep on loving one another as the Lord has loved us. Welcome the stranger, care for the suffering, visit those who are shut in, be generous with the poor, and support each other in caring respect. And may our generous God bless us always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, serve the Lord.